Well, my shows are quite interesting. I connect with loved ones. So everyone who comes to my show, I connect with them. Could be their mum, their dad, their best friend, their child, their aunt, their uncle, their grandparent.
But why do they want to talk to the living?
Well, first of all, the spirits want to connect with us just to say, hey, by the way, I'm okay. And secondly, they want to say that there is a life after death. And of course, they want to say that we will be waiting for you. And so obviously, the audience want to hear this, and they want a message of hope. And many times we hear a happy birthday, or we hear them say, I watched you get married. Or we hear all sorts of things that will come. And it's amazing when the person in the audience hears that, it's such a joyous occasion that it just gives a lot of closure and healing and comfort to that person.
Yes, because you actually do often get quite private during your shows.
Yes,
How do you
I can.
find the natural balance in what to say to the audience?
It's very hard to know what to say. I had a situation only a few nights ago where I could not complete a reading on stage. And normally, I would say, and most readings I can, I like to judge what I can actually say on stage. I like to see if I've got any children in the audience, first of all. And, I'm very cautious. But a lot of the time, I'm aware, but this one time I couldn't. It was very graphic, it was very detailed, it was about a murder. And so I said to the people, I said I'd speak to them afterwards. And I did, because I could not allow everybody in the audience to have the image that I was holding in my own head, to have them taken and what that taken with them. So there has to be a balance. I have to give some form of positivity without scaring everybody.
I have been reading your blog, and you write there that when you travel, you experience a lot of love in meeting with the audience, but you also experience meeting people that are skeptical and perhaps even scared of what you do. Why do you think that is?
Well, first of all, let's address the love thing. And with what I do, everybody wants to connect with their loved ones because they love them, they miss them. But then we have to look at it as the opposite effect. Love, the opposite effect is fear. And I know this personally because my own father is probably or was probably one of the biggest skeptics going. And I understood it. And my father was like, if you can't touch it, he didn't want to understand it. He needed to experience it. And he was very fearful. He was very fearful. He didn't want to accept it. He wanted to believe that when you're dead, you're dead, because he couldn't comprehend it. And really, it was something that he had to get into his head. And I have many skeptics that come, many, many skeptics, and you can see them. And they sit there like this. And then you can see them kind of open up. And I read for them. And then you can see them be, well, yeah, you know. And then suddenly I'll mention a few things that I wouldn't have been able to Google or I wouldn't have been able to find out. And they're like, wow. And you can see them open up.
But in your personal life, you've had quite a bit of challenges.
Oh, yes.
Yes, you have divorced. And you became a single mother,
Yes.
and also you had to fight cervical cancer
Twice, yes, I did.
twice. So, how do you feel that all this has affected your work, the way you do today?
Well, I mean, it's all in my book. I mean, I've been homeless, I've had cervical cancer, hysterectomy. So, single mom, divorce, the whole thing. It's a challenge, and life presents challenges. And at the end of the day, if I didn't have those challenges, then I would not be able to help other people. I would not be able to understand what other people are going through because I would not be able to empathize with them.
Right.
Mm. You know, and so I know what it's like to be in hospital. I know what it's like to have a near-death experience. I know what it's like when your son comes up to you and says, "Mum, are you going to die?" And for that moment, your heart breaks.
Lisa, you have written two spiritual books mm-hmm. till now. Can we hope for another one?
Actually, I am writing another one. And strangely enough, it actually started here in Norway.
Really?
It started here in Norway back in March, the conception of it. And it really didn't take shape until this trip, when I just fully developed it. And it's on soulmates and soul families, and how we embrace soul families, and how we can actually really attract our soulmate, and who are soulmates, and why is it that we are so attracted to certain people, and why is it that we are not attracted to others? And so it's quite interesting. So that's the next book.